Recently, I was approached by a bourbon company. They wanted me to come up with a box that would display their bottles in a unique and curious way. I came up with some samples, and in the process, I found out that you can really make a box that looks a little bit more complicated than it really is. And so I got to thinking that it'd be fun to show you guys how to make a really cool box. Maybe it's a gift box, maybe it's something for yourself. I've taken a bottle of gin here from our local distillery. I'm gonna use this as an example, how to take measurements for it and house this perfectly in whatever box you're gonna make. So we're gonna figure out the dimensions of whatever we wanna hold in this box. We're gonna miter all of the corners, just like what we do with a picture frame. We're then going to skin it and cap it. Once we do that, we're gonna cut it, we're gonna open it up, put our hinges in it, and then do all the fun little details to it.
I'm using a domino here, but feel free to use whatever tool or technique works best for you. Something I don't show here is you're gonna wanna go ahead and check this for square before you completely tighten up those clamps. Once you take it out of the clamps, you're gonna wanna use something like a sanding block just to give it a good once-over, making sure that the skin or the lid fits real well on there.
Measure the height and the width of your box, and then go ahead and tack on another 3/8 inch to these measurements. Cut these pieces accordingly, check them against the box. If you like what you see, go ahead and run a bead of glue. Then clamp it up. Make sure that you have a nice little overhang so you have a little bit of play on all four of these edges. Take your time clamping it. Make sure you're diligent, making sure that there's no gaps in that joint. Find yourself a good flush trim bit with a bottom bearing on it. Here I'm using the Ultimate Bit by Whiteside.
All right, so we find ourselves here at a completely enclosed box, which doesn't do us a whole lot of good. But now is the fun part. Now is where we're gonna take this and do some fun details. When you guys weren't watching, I made a second box, and I just did this just to go a different direction to show the opportunities that we have. Since this is a little bit smaller, I'm gonna go ahead and take the router and do a nice chamfer on this. This one, I'm gonna take it over the table saw, and we might even do even a deeper chamfer, being how we have more surface area here. But once again, this is the type of thing you guys can take, run with. You could do roundovers, coves, whatever you really feel. There's a lot of different things we can do.
I'm making a detail for the leather strap. I'm using a bowl and tray router bit with a top bearing on it. This specific one is made by Whiteside.
Now, if you end up going the route of making this little indentation for the leather strap, there's two ways you can go about it. You can kind of willy-nilly it. If you're doing a lot of them, it might pay off to go ahead and make some kind of jig for it.
Here's an opportunity to take this box making process in a direction that suits your own ideas or creativity. There's nothing saying that you have to cut this straight. Feel free to take this to the chop saw, put an angle on it, or even the bandsaw. The domino really comes in handy at this point for this application. I'm using it to create this slot for the leather strap.
Now comes the fun part of mortising in the hinge. I'm gonna go ahead and use a clamp to clamp these two pieces together just so we get that perfect alignment. I'm gonna mark it out and then use that chisel to make way for that hinge. I'm gonna walk you through another way to mortise out those hinges. This is typically my preferred way, and if you're making multiple boxes, I'd recommend doing this. I'm marking out my hinge on a scrap piece of 3/4 inch plywood. Then I'm gonna use a chop saw and cut it out, making a template so I can then use a flush trim bit with a bearing on top. This will make my mortise. Once we give it a good little sand, then we get to dive into the part that we've all been waiting for. I'm using a finish called Surfix, made by Festool here, but of course use whatever works best for you. If you've never worked with leather before, this might be the perfect opportunity to do so. The tools and the hardware are fairly inexpensive and easy to work with, and I find that leather adds so much to any project. You can typically find leather scraps at your local leather store or online. It's typically pretty inexpensive, if not free.
As you can see here, we did the finishing touches. We did the oil, we did the leather. Here's how the gin box ended up. Just real cool how to display something like that. It really makes something a little bit more unique and special. This guy I had in mind when I was coming up with the dimensions. I had some ping pong paddles I wanted to give somebody, so I thought this would be a nice display. As far as these other guys go, I just wanted to bring these out to give you guys an idea that there are so many other possibilities out there. This guy actually cut on the chop saw, and this guy back to the bandsaw. But you know, let your mind go wild on these. Come up with some interesting, unique ways to open it up. Once you get that initial box made, then you can do anything from there. Have fun with it, and I hope you learned something new. Hope this expanded some of your ideas on how to woodwork.